In this video, I'm gonna show you how to do a cool vintage mascot design like this one right here. I'm gonna show you step by step and all the different things I use, all the fonts and everything. I'm also gonna show you the vintage templates, the mascot templates that they have. There's a lot of them on Kiddo if you wanna go that route too. Let's go. Hey everyone, it's Juno with Detour Shirts. In this video, I wanted to show you how to do a vintage mascot design. Now, there's a lot of them out there. I've been noticing a lot of them on Twitter, as well as the videos that Kiddo put out. They're so cool. I think this is the next wave of vintage stuff going on. I've noticed it kind of trending and stuff. I haven't noticed it being top sellers in Amazon, but I think it can do well in places like Redbubble and TeePublic and things like that, where it's more artistic. So this is really cool. You can make your own mascots, or you can, they have a bunch of mascots already made, so you can use those as well. It's as simple or complex as you want it on Kiddo. So you know you have templates over there, or you can also build things now. So you can actually put together the face and the arms and the legs and color it different things, and it's really cool. So I'm gonna show you how to do it in Kiddo step by step on how I did mine, and then I can show you, before that I'm gonna show you all the templates. So if you don't wanna build your own, you can start from a template and just have some really cool ones. So let's get into Kiddo right now and I'll show you what I mean. All right, so here we are on Kiddo, kiddo.com. You can see right away on the homepage, at least for me, you can see some of the mascot designs that they have here. Really cool, very vintage, which is perfect because Kiddo has a lot of vintage fonts to go well with it and vintage graphics, so it makes a lot of sense. You can see one right here, one right here, one right here. I'm just gonna type in mascot so we can kind of narrow them down. So I'm gonna type in M-A-S-C-O-T. We got mascot t-shirt design and mascot. I'm just gonna do mascot, just have them all. So it could be mascot posters, mascot t-shirts. It's gonna take a little while to load, but you're gonna see, like, there's some really cool ones. So if you don't wanna design your own, like I'm gonna show today, you can start with these. Like, there's the coffee one, there's earth and heart here, there's this flower, trick-or-treats coming, Halloween, right? You got that, so you got a bunch of those right here. You can do it with different things. And I think this is one of the tutorials from Kiddo where they did a lemon right here. There's a heart, diamond, like everything. Like, there's a fun one with a pineapple. So for Earth Day, that would be really cool. For people that love music, there's a pizza. Like, there's something for everybody. You can see there's not a lot. Like, there's not a ton, but there's a lot to start with. So I think more and more people are gonna build off here. So, I mean, you can start with a mascot here and then add text behind it. Like, this one has six of them, that one has six of them. So I mean, some pretty cool ones. I really like this one right here. So I'm gonna show you how to do one on our own. I'm gonna do one that they don't have. So I'm not gonna take a mascot that they already built out. I'm gonna build one with arms and legs and face and all of that, okay? So let's do that. I'm gonna do a new project and let it pull up here, and I'm gonna go to pod presets. It's gonna be a t-shirt for Amazon, and it will work for Redbubble and everything. So there's a standard Redbubble if you want that. If you do Printful or TeePublic, you can do any of those as well. But I'm just gonna stick to Amazon, even though I think this would sell better on a place like Redbubble and TeePublic, but it may stand out in, depending on the phrase that you have. If it's a funny phrase that people like on Amazon, it could work too. So first things first, let's do the mascot. I'm gonna show you where the mascots are first. So let's go elements and then illustrations. And if you scroll down, you'll see mascots right here, right? And the best way, I think, to see this is to expand this right here, because it's a lot. So you can see there's some basic ones like the earth here, the sun, like these are really good. Just think of different phrases that go with coffee, you know, for people who love coffee or people who love donuts or people who love burgers. Like, there's a lot to start with, but there isn't one, at least I didn't see one. Maybe there is one. I didn't see a baseball one in here. And I could be wrong because there's a basketball one here, but we're gonna build a baseball one that's not on here. Okay, so I'm gonna close this first. Let's close this. And then let's go to elements again, and I'm gonna just type in baseball. And then you can do this with any object. I typically like the rounder ones or something with more space. So I'm gonna pick this one just so it's there, right? And I'm gonna do that. Now, You can make it any color. This one's blue, but typically baseballs are white, so I'm gonna change this to white. And I like the stitching to be red, but we could do it black or whatever we want. So maybe red. I'll just pick it so we have a color. Oh, make sure we pick that one, and then red over here and up like that. That's cool. All right. Next thing we're gonna do is add arms, face, and legs. So let's go back to our thing here. All right, and then expand it. Now I could have just the hands, but I want the arms too. So I'm gonna pick some, I'm gonna pick a foot here. So this one's gonna be my feet. Let's see. I want kind of like a, I don't know, this could work. This one, this is cool, thumbs up, right? Maybe a thumbs up the other way, maybe two thumbs up. I'll do this one. And then I want some eyes, so I'll pick one with, I'm gonna look for one with lashes, because I'm thinking of an idea like baseball mom. So let me do, oh, this one has lashes, but it has a nose and a mouth, so I wanna do one without, yeah, this could work. And then I want a mouth like just the lips. Let's try this one. Okay, so I should have enough things here. I'm gonna close this. And let's move things out of the way. All right. I want my feet to flip the other way. So you can hit right click on that and hit flip vertical. Cool. I'm gonna put this down like this and move it to the back. So again, right click and move it to the back. All right, this one I'm gonna make smaller. I'm trying to get the arms and the legs kind of the same width. Good, like that. And maybe this guy, same thing. Try and make it like the same width. That's about right. All right, and this, so this one's gonna go in the back too, to back. Maybe that's a good one, but we'll see. And then we have these eyes here. Cool. And then these lips here. That's neat. Okay, so I can color anything. I could color the lips the red color that we had right here. Oh, maybe we want a darker red. I'm okay with the shoes, that color. That's kind of cool. And let me make it down further. So you can see I can do it with anything, right? I don't need this one unless I want three arms, but I don't want three arms. Okay. So I'm gonna select all of these, move it down like that. The next thing I wanna do is maybe put a hat on here so we can add some things. There wasn't any hats that I liked on there, so I'm gonna just look for baseball cap. I'm gonna go to elements, illustrations, make sure you're in illustrations, and then do, I think you don't have to be in illustrations, but anyway, baseball cap. Now there's a bunch here, but I want something just a little bit thicker just to match. So I'm gonna keep scrolling down till I find something. Okay, I found this one. I'll put it on here. Yeah, that could work. Okay, so one thing that I notice is there's black outlines here, right? But there's no black outline here. So what we can do is when you click on this, we can do border weight and do black. Or just pick that black that's there and then add a stroke on it. And that's gonna just make it feel like they're the same thing, right? So I have that black, and so I'm gonna do the same thing here. I'm gonna put a border of black here and just increase the border until it kind of matches. So I'm gonna zoom in here until this kind of matches that. So you see that stroke? That could work. Cool. And we can change the color on these too. So if we wanna, you know, make this more white, we can. If we wanna make this this color white, we can. And so on, right? And maybe this is red because we have red in here just to kind of tie it in. So I'm gonna pick the same color red that's here, or maybe this one, right? Cool. So now once we have our mascot the way we want it, I'm gonna select it all and just group it. Good. So now I can move this anywhere I want. So that's really important. So what we're going to do is we're going to add some words now and some graphics. So that's not by itself. One of the things that you might have seen on those templates is that a lot of times they do this arc thing because it looks more vintage, and we can do that too. So I'm going to do the words I'm going to use is All-Star Baseball Mama or something like that. So let's do that since there's eyelashes here. So I'm going to type a T on my keyboard, and there's that. So I'm going to move this up here, and I'm going to do all star, all in caps, AL space dash star baseball, right? And I'm going to stretch it out, make it bigger, like 600, something like that. And then let's see, I'm going to make it a circle, boom. Make the circle smaller, right? Kind of like that. And then I'm going to look for a font. I don't want to use Roboto. Let's see. Yeah, this Titan one is good. That's good. Okay. You see how it kind of curves around that right there? That's good. All right. All-Star Baseball Mom. Great. And then I'm going to do another one, or I need mom underneath. So let's type another T, boom, bring this down here. I'm gonna use another font that looks like a sports font. So let's see, I think it's all the way down here. I've seen it before. Like it's a cursive font. It's called Sun, not Sun Drop, Sunshade, Sunship. Yeah, it's a lot of sun. I think all of these are really cool. But I'm going to do that and make this bigger. I don't know, 300, maybe bigger. And I'm going to do Mama. Oops, not all caps. I think that Mama is good. But I want to do some of the glyphs. So I'm going to come in here. This one has some really cool glyphs. You can click on here and you can see I'm looking for an A. So lots of cool A's here. Not that A. I'm gonna scroll down some more. So here it has some of the like the flourishes and things like that. And here's this A. Just type it like that and get rid of the other A. Cool, I'll make this bigger. I'm gonna fill the space. So another thing that Kiddo's really good at is font effects or text effects. So I'm going to come in here and I'm going to do a text effects. I'm going to do that. And maybe the outline is black. Good. And this is black as well. And then we do the text color actually red. Let's do this one. And maybe we want like a muted red. What if we did? Yeah, that feels like more vintage, right? I think that feels good. All right, and then we can make the effects even bigger or smaller. I think I got 12 right there. That's pretty cool. All right, we're gonna do something similar to this one. We'll do the same thing, text effects. I'm gonna do the same here with the background of black and the stroke of black, right? And I'm gonna do the text. Let's make the text white. That's really cool. This one white? Oh, that's the back. Okay. All right. But you notice one thing right here is that it's overlapping. So one thing you can do is I'm gonna copy and paste one over the top. So I'm gonna copy, paste, and I think it pasted on the top. Let's see what happens when I take the effect away. All right, so the one in the back is the one that we want to do an outline more. And I'm going to move my face over here so you can see. I'm going to go to layers. We have the two mama one. So the one in the back, let's make that even bigger, the width here. Boom, isn't that cool? That's a cool design right there. And let's make this another vintage color. Let's say instead of white, I'm on the top one again. Let's pick like a, I don't know, maybe something light like this, or oh yeah, like a light blue. Yeah, that's cool. All right. Yeah, and so we can start making everything those colors, right? So I'm gonna double click on here. Instead of this blue, we're gonna use that light blue. Let's do that. That's cool. Well, maybe it does need that darker blue a little bit, just to give it some. Yeah, that's cool. And then maybe, I don't know, will the lips look right with that? Yeah, I think it will. And then the baseball with the lighter one. Yeah, that's looking cool. All right, so I think we still need some things to fill the space here. I'm gonna do like a starburst. So I'm gonna come in here. There's so many illustrations and ornaments. Let's go ornaments. Yeah, this ray right here, boom. That's cool, right? Put that in the back. We can right click and put it to the back. Boom. I wanna do some, like, since it's all star, let's do some stars. Where did I see? Oh yeah, there you go. Spot elements. I'm just gonna click that one. Boom. I wanna make these like more yellow. So let's see what we got, like maybe a muted yellow. Yeah, I think that works. Oh, we should color this the right color too. Is this, there we go. Where is it? Oh yeah, we got that. Cool. All right, maybe we could even go softer. Let's try. Yeah. All right, so I'm gonna, there's more stars here. There's another one there. Yeah, so we'll make sure this is the same yellow, like that. And we can put these anywhere. Like maybe we put one here. Maybe we put this one. I'm holding down option and dragging. I'm gonna flip it so it's different, right? And then maybe one more down here, just to give it some space. And I think we need some things right here. So let's go back. Let's see what kind of illustrations. I'm looking for like a flower. There's these flowers. I think that's cool. I saw some vintage flowers. Yeah, these would work. I don't know, this one's kind of cool. Let's do that. Right, see, I'm just filling that space and I'm holding down option, drag it here. I kind of like how that one is. So I'm gonna flip this one to match. Flip horizontal, boom. So let's see how this looks like on a mock-up. So white shirt, it can be a different color shirt, but I think it works well on white. Let's do a quick mock-up. I'm gonna hit mock-up. And we can put it on a person. Let's do this person right here, baseball mom. Oh, pretty cool, right? We can make it that big, up like that, or maybe straight on, like do this person right here. Yeah, so you can actually see it on a t-shirt here in Kittle to see if it works. And you could use these, like if you're selling on Etsy or your own Shopify store, you can use these as one of the pictures on there so people can see what it looks like on a t-shirt, right? Pretty cool. So that's it, super easy tutorial. If you don't wanna create your own, again, there's lots of things on here on templates, like all of these things. I think they're really cool. You can see sometimes they don't go over, they have the straight, and there's so many different ways you can do this, right? This one has a different background. Now you can see how people put it together, right? The rounded thing, the stars, the background is a little different, and things like that. So have fun with this. Use mascots for different things. Make your own mascot and create lots of these for Q4. So there you go. That's how easy it is to create vintage mascot designs using Kittle. It has everything you need to do those. I love that they have the vintage text and the vintage graphics and now the vintage mascots. You can put it all together and you have the mockups on there, which is really cool. If you want to see more Kittle tutorials, Kittle videos, I have this playlist right here with a lot of Kittle content. You can go through that and see all the different things that Kittle can do. It does a lot of cool stuff. So thanks again for watching. And as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one.